I think maybe one way to sum that up is I've often wondered, and I'm sure you've wondered this as well too, and it'll actually often happen for me with music, where just yesterday there was a song on at this restaurant I was at, and it just reminded me that that's the only song from that artist I've ever heard, yet it's literally one of the most popular songs through all of time, and then nothing else ever kind of gets released or makes its way out into the world after that. So I'm curious, you know, what are some of those insights that just resonated with you or were aha moments around the final mile?
I talked to a lot of folks about this in different disciplines, including people in the arts and music, et cetera. And a couple of thoughts came out of those conversations. Number one is oftentimes the cost of getting attention is that you're no longer paying attention. And so sometimes if you imagine, anyone can identify with this, when you post a new piece of content on Instagram or Twitter, and then suddenly you find yourself really tuned into the traction it's getting and what people are saying about it and commenting against what you said and whatever. And so your attention gets consumed suddenly as a result of your creation. And so you're unlikely to create in that zone because all you're doing is you're tuning into what people are saying about your creation. Imagine that at 1,000,000,000 times, where all people want to do is hear that song again and talk about that song. And you could go for 10 years and never get through your own fan mail. And so if you're really seduced by your attention that you're getting, you will not create anymore. And so you wonder how these incredibly brilliant creative people only did one thing and never again. Maybe it's because they felt in some ways victim to that. And maybe that's also why some of the great creatives are introverts, you know, and why they actually don't enjoy that fanfare and they tune it out. I think so. A few tactics here. I mean, number one is to always revert to your curiosity. The power and gravity of your curiosity must outweigh the gravity of the attention you're getting for your work. I think number two is the idea of killing your creations once they're done. That era of my work is now dead to me. And now I'm focused on this. And that's an important thing to do. I remember there was a presentation at one of our 99U conferences, the Behance conference we used to hold every year, where a speaker talked about the idea of, for a creative person, are they their work or not? Are you your work? Am I my work? And some part of me says yes, because I'm passionate about my work. I care about my work. I'm not just shoveling snow, although that might be someone's passion. But, you know, it's not mine. But I have found I'm fortunate. I get to do something I feel really passionate about. But that's also dangerous, because once you are your work, your identity is tied up in what you're making, then what does that mean once what you're making is done, out there, over, uninteresting? And, you know, does that mean that your identity is over? I think there's something to be said about keeping them separate.